Well, this is Onderon. It looks like there's a long line to get into the Isis starport.
Something feels wrong here. A great disturbance here in orbit, and again on the planets below.
I guess this blockade is a symptom of larger problems on Onderon. Looks like we're about to find out. I'm receiving a message from some Colonel Tobin, patching it through.
The Ebon Hawk. I was told to expect your arrival. I don't know your business on Onderon, but it ends here.
Taking some hits! We can try to fight back, or I can outrun them and hide us on the jungle moon nearby. It's your call. You know, just once I wish someone was glad to see us. But no, if it isn't weapons pointed at our heads, it's someone trying to blast us out of the sky. I remember the days when welcoming committee used to mean something, without being followed by blaster bolts. Looks like one of the moons of Onderon. Not sure which one. It's mostly jungle and mountain. I did pick up the remains of an old outpost near here. Maybe that's why there's all these clearings around. Maybe they were once settlements.
There were no settlements here. Those clearings were most likely once craters or crash sites.
Crash sites?
This is Duxon, where the Mandalorians began their crusade against the Republic. The remains of whatever outposts you detected here are military ones. We should be careful.
This is where the Mandalorian War started? This doesn't look like much of a battlefield.
Much is buried here, and there is much that should remain buried.
It's taken a little damage, nothing too serious. I'm shutting down all unnecessary systems until we make repairs. It'll keep us from being a target. Well, the space battle's still going on overhead. Since they were so eager to use our hull for target practice, I doubt they're just going to forget us. Well, I don't like it. Onderon is about as far from the core as you can get and still be in the Republic. But even out here, the locals have heard of us.
We're lucky I was able to find this place to land. Looks like something has cleared away the jungle in a few spots around here.
Until the ship is repaired, we're not going anywhere. Unless you can find another route to Onderon, we should sit tight.
There may be a means to get to Onderon by another route. The Force has guided us here for a reason. We should explore our surroundings. There is something here.
Something? Oh, there's something here, all right. Predators. Not small flit darters, but big, mean, nasty predators.
Nevertheless, we should explore our surroundings. And that nearby outpost would be as good a place as any to begin.
Well, if you go, be careful. No telling what other ships were forced down in the battle.
I have a feeling the ship will not be repaired until our business here is concluded. Do I make myself clear?
Yeah, I understand. What's so important about this place?
This is where the Mandalorian Wars began. She fought here once, and there are things here she must see.
She fought here? Why didn't she say anything?
Do you speak of all your battles? Or are there some you wish to forget?
still going on. The Hawk's sensors just picked up a contact heading to the moon. Most of the ship's systems are powered down, so it's about all I got. That ship may have landed nearby, though. Or it may be on the other side of the moon. So you might want to prepare for another friendly Onderon welcome.
Donos Emerekith, Wanarak Lorachi Drumka Sa Inchobin Sasha, Dosimana Rachata, the Ranam Losibu and Asarats, Krema Sukun Ratungala, Chawi Moju Kosoracha, the Ranam Losibu and Asarats, Krema Sukun Ratungala, Chawi Moju Kosoracha, Donos Emerekith. Wanarak Lorachi Drumka Sa Inchobin Sasha, Dosimana Rachata, Donos Emeregith, Wanarak.
Yes.
You let the ship escape? I will deal with your failure later, Captain. But for now, find that ship. Our ally has indicated that the Jedi hasn't left the system yet. Send a detachment to Duxon. If you find anything, alert me immediately. Now get out of my sight.
Thank you.
not the skeletal remnant of a war long past. That is a recent kill. It appears that Duxon isn't as abandoned as we would be led to believe. A few days, a standard week at most. The jungle has not left its mark on his armor yet. You probably have more questions, but let us press forward. You may find the answers you seek. Yes.
After Exar Kun's defeat, some of us call it home. Why are you trespassing here? We expected as much. Few visit Duxon by choice. We have orders to escort you to our camp. Our leader wants to speak to you.
This may prove of use to us. Let us hear his words and see if they hold any value.
So you're the intruder. Our sensors picked up your handiwork in space. I am Mandalore, leader of the Mandalorians. Scattered, perhaps. But we're still alive. Alive and rebuilding. This used to be the heart of the Mandalorian war effort. From this complex, we commanded an armada that had the Republic on the run. It didn't last. Covert camps are not meant to attract attention. Because we conquered them, the people of Onderon still hold a grudge against the Mandalorians. So we keep our presence here a secret. Mandalorians have a rapport with this jungle. Every moment here is a struggle. All creatures gripped in a constant war for survival. The sole purpose of the weak is to feed the strong. We train here and learn the lessons of the jungle. The beasts also help us keep our edge. So it's transportation you want. It so happens I have a small shuttle that's more than capable of running the Onderon military blockade. I make occasional trips to Isis for information and supplies. If you want to go with me, you're going to have to prove your worth. It's Mandalorian business, not yours. I could, but I don't know you. Once I get to know you, I might tell you more, but not now. Figure it out yourself. Ask around. See if you can make yourself useful, or something that'll show what you're made of. There is one thing. Before your ship landed, we were preparing some demolition work. All the activity forced my men to stop before they finished. The charges need to be detonated before anybody comes across them, so all you'd have to do is flip a switch. You asked if there was anything you could do, and I told you. Nothing in this jungle is as simple as it seems, though. I'll let Kex know that you check out. We found more gear than we can use, so you can trade with him if you need some more supplies. Be careful in the jungle. Our patrols have stopped until the space traffic dies down. The challenging beasts have been cleared from the area, but what's left might still be too much for you.
Our Mandalorian! Our training homes us. The galaxy will clear up.
So, you're the Jedi the camp's been talking about. Are you planning on exploring the jungles to the south? I'm Zarga. I instruct our rawr Mandalorian recruits in the ways of discipline and battle. I sent one of my warriors, Kumas, into the jungle. It's been 3 days, and I want you to bring back his corpse and his survival pack. If Kumas wasn't dead, he'd be back already. If you find his body, just bring it back. Good point. I don't want his body, just his equipment. Field strip the corpse and bring the gear back. Mandalore will gather the
This is our battle circle. You should leave us. This place is for Mandalorians alone. Even if the sergeant lets you fight with us, you will never truly be one of us.
Though the Jedi Order isn't completely dead, you always had hidden strengths. Very hard for even the wisest Mandalore to judge and predict. I have studied much of the Jedi since our defeat. I would be honored to cross blades with you in the battle circle. You talk with the sergeant. Today is his day to preside over the circle. Each fight is different because the Mandalorian with greater honor dictates the terms of the engagement. But there will be no terms if we fight. Everyone else will deny you your lightsaber and the use of your force. But I want to fight you with all your skill. Victory isn't important in the battle circle. What is important is discovering more about yourself and your opponent. This is not a battlefield, Jedi. If it were, I trust you wouldn't have the same opinion. I prepare and train, readying my mind and weaponry for a real challenge. Peace is not our natural element. Mandalorians handle it differently. I focus on educating myself in the martial techniques I will need to succeed in the next war. No, it is up to the sergeant. The battle circle was not designed to settle petty vendettas and rivalries. Its primary purpose has always been teaching. Learning from books or holovids is useless when battle rages and soldiers are dying around you. Real knowledge can only be gained through combat. Perhaps we can learn from one another in time.
So, the Jedi comes to grace us. The battle circle is reserved only for real warriors. Your Jedi ways won't help you here. Jedi rely too much on their vaunted powers. They lose touch of the power of their arms and feet. Without your force, would you be a match for even the lowliest of Mandalorian warriors? If you want to try and fight us on our terms, that can be arranged. We are not merchants. We are Mandalorians. The only thing gained and lost here is honor, and perhaps some skill, if you have the capacity to learn. Be careful when you ridicule a Mandalorian. If Mandalore hadn't ordered us to... Is there anything else you want to talk about? You are new here, so you will fight Davril. He is young and has not been able to prove himself in battle. Davril, what are your terms?
No weapons, no Jedi tricks, and no items. Just fist and foot. A true test of strength.
Put your weapon away, Jedi. Don't step out of the circle and pull any death blow. No one dies in the battle circle. Step into the battle circle. Now you will experience a true fight. Between Jedi and Davril is over. The Jedi is the clear and honorable victor. Davril is just a recruit. I'm not surprised you won this fight. A challenger has expressed interest in fighting you. As little honors you have gained, it is sufficient to accept his request. Let me know if you would fight again. I have lost. But this was no true contest. Jedi are skilled warriors, and I am young. I will train very hard to match you in combat next time. But there are others already here who are more than your equal. Braylor is one of the mightiest among us. He could teach you humility. Here to watch a fight or to participate? After defeating Davril, you have gained some small honor. There is a challenger for you. He is Kex, the quartermaster. Since he is the challenger, you get to choose the terms. As quartermaster, he has little opportunity for any glory in training. He isn't as skilled as Davril. The battle circle is for training. It is something neither one of you are complete. I will send a runner to Kex. Prepare yourself for your fight, Jedi. Victor, if you want to fight again, let me know. Here to watch a fight or to participate? You choose to fight again. Now face a real Mandalorian warrior. Tagrin, what are your terms?
Just fist and foot like you fight with Davril. Nothing else.
Tagrin chooses to fight hand to hand. Remember, no weapons allowed and absolutely no use of your force. Between Jedi and Tagrin is over. The Jedi is the clear and honorable victor. You have fought well today. The only Mandalorians left for you to fight are our champions. No one can fight a champion until they have proven themselves worthy. And it must be real proof. The kind you gain fighting foes to the death.
And a champion must observe and deem your actions worthy. There are two champions in the camp, Braylor and Kelborn. Until you prove yourself in their eyes, the battle circle is closed to you.
So the Jedi Order isn't completely dead. You always had hidden strengths. I have studied much of the Jedi since our defeat.
For Mandalore! For Mandalore!
I could only do that if I observed you fight an enemy in real combat. I have, but the rules cannot be changed. The other champion, Kelborn, is in the
Alright, stand back. Let's see if that... Sith's blood! Fixing anything in this rot-infested place is an uphill battle. This jungle attacks anything made by man. Restoring the generators and computer systems is no easy task. I'll take whatever help I can get. Whatever wires and tech haven't been corroded by the jungle are at least 10 years old.
What's the problem?
I'm trying to get the relay dish operational, but several components are broken and need repair. Without the relay, we're vulnerable to attack, especially right now. Your space battle may have attracted unwanted attention. And our shuttle sensors can't cover the whole moon. Oh, seems just about everything involved with the relay dish is broken. I've been trying to fix it for weeks and still no success.
I can take a look at it, if you will permit it.
If you think you can help, there's the broken cables right over there. And the relay maintenance structure's behind me. You can find the telemetry computer in there. The only thing I know for sure is we need a new phase pulse converter for the tracking computer.
That part's rare enough in most spaceports. Finding one here would be difficult.
We actually already found one in an old weapons cache, but Flaming Kennox ate it. We checked the cache manifests, and that's the only one that was in storage. It's probably the only working converter on this moon. They're vermin, and no challenge for a Mandalorian. Since they provide no sport, we ignore them. Just gut every Kennox you come across. You wouldn't believe the things you can find in those little beasts. All right then, come back when you have the converter and we can see about getting these systems working again.
You hear the gloat over your victories in the battle circle. Save it for someone else. So why are you back? Yeah, I do. I don't know why Mandalore would let some outsider roam around our camp without an escort. If it were up to me, you would have been shot on sight. Mandalore must think you're something special. I won't. As long as the Mandalore's orders stand. If he wants you dead, though, then I'm gonna be the first one gunning for you. It's bad enough I have to stand here and pass out supplies while the others go on patrol. I'm not gonna disgrace myself further by being your guide. The only advice I'll give you is, when you're in the jungle, shoot anything that moves. Blasters, energy shields, armor, and other...
Find some entertainment in clearing out the worst of the beasts. But without our patrols, some of the larger beasts may be around. None of us will be around to bail you out of trouble. You've been warned. Our sensors picked up 3 ships landing in this area after the space battle. If any of the Onderon military come searching for those ships, we don't want them finding our base. I don't know. It was some sort of freighter. It didn't land at any of the clearings along the path. Knowing some of the larger Duxun beasts, the crew's probably already dead. Who knows? Our relay dish is down, and until Zuko repairs it, we're blind. The Onderon military has cordoned off the planet, so there shouldn't be anybody else down here. Still, our sensors occasionally pick up signals on the surface.
Signals? What signals?
It's like someone is searching the planet, and doing so under the noses of the military. Whoever they are, they've stayed clear of us. I don't know. Duxun's all jungle except for this camp. If you want to pitch in, go ahead. Zuka hasn't been able to get the damn thing up and running. You can find him in the eastern side of camp, just south of the hangars. Look for the sparking wires, and he won't be far. We heard reports of a Zakeg wandering the paths around here. They're a good challenge for Mandalorians. If you see one, stay out of its way. Without us to back you up, you'll be dead in seconds. It's a huge red lizard that's built like a Baragwan battle tank. It has a hide so thick it might as well be Durasteel plating. We keep clearing them out of the area, but they keep coming back. They're tough opponents for non-Mandalorians. You fight a Zakeg. If you survived such a battle, you'd gain much honor. Strong words. It would be amusing to see you try to kill such a beast. Try the outlying jungle paths if you're determined to seek one out. And bring me back a trophy from your kill as proof of the deed.
Progress with the repairs or the phase pulse converter?
You managed that? I thought that was a lost cause. Now if I can only get the phase pulse converter and the power working, the sensors will be operational again.
Damn it.
Any progress with the repairs?
That's the best thing I've heard in weeks. I'll be sure to tell Mandalore about your help. Look, I have some extra parts and computer spikes. Take them. You can probably make better use of them than I can.
You finally arrived, Jedi. I seek to reclaim the honor that you stole from me. I challenge you here, outside of the battle circle. This time, we fight to the death. I was too young to fight in the Mandalorian Wars. With our clans scattered, there was no opportunity to prove myself. Years ago, young Mandalorians would fly point in a basilisk, laying waste to anything before them, at the forefront of battle. But this has been denied me. What little honor I have earned, you stripped from me in the battle circle. This I won't allow. You would deny my request? I want to fight here, in front of other Mandalorians, to prove my worth. Do not shame me further. There were no wars to fight, no great enemies to destroy. I wish this was a different age, where our armadas were a force to be feared. A Zakeg? Those are the deadliest beasts in this part of the jungle. Patrols are right to be cautious about them. I'll do what I must to prove myself to the other Mandalorians, but fighting a Zakeg would be a short-lived honor. What? Yes, I suppose that is possible. We would both gain recognition from that battle. Your plan is acceptable to me. Together we will destroy the Zakeg. I will meet you there. If you head out into the jungle, stay alert. Our patrols keep the area clear of the more dangerous beasts, but a lot of the smaller ones still infest the paths.
Yeah? See what you have. No, you're still missing a lens. Something else I can help you with?
Keeping its eye on emissions to a minimum. Our sensors almost didn't pick it up.
Just this corpse here. Looks like a scout, and pretty green, too. The fool walked right into a group of Canucks at North Park. He can't have been the only one crawling around here. If there's more, we need to take them out. You up for some action? Good to hear it. There's more of these scouts in the jungle. There's many paths, and I don't want them to slip by. If we split up, we should be able to find their scouts, if you're up for it. I'm going to take up a position to the east. You go west. I'll make sure none of them get past me.
Jungle just never ends.
Lieutenant, two of our scout patrols haven't reported back.
Two more? Nothing is worth this.
More beasts!
Everyone, attack!
Lawn.
He got swarmed by those little beasts. I think they're called Canucks.
I hope this mission is worth it to the Colonel. If not... Wait, did you hear that?
That's her! Get her! Let me handle this.
Let us end this.
Take them down.
Scouts, but they started shooting as soon as they saw me. I heard blaster rifle fire coming from deeper in the jungle. You find anything? Surprised they wouldn't talk to you. I thought their grudge was only with Mandalorians. Find out anything useful from them? Colonel, huh? Could be Colonel Tobin. Tobin is General Vaklu's personal cat hound. If he's on your trail, you might want to steer clear of Onderon. I'm not surprised. He was probably acting on orders from Vaklu. If so, you've made some dangerous enemies. General Vaklu is the cousin of Queen Talia. He's also in charge of the Onderon military. He led the Onderon resistance when we occupied their world during the Mandalorian Wars. He was a worthy foe. Maybe more than a match for you. Mandalore needs to know about the scouts. I'll let him know your role in dealing with them. They're Onderon military, although they were trying to be secret about it. I've got a feeling you're going to need all the help you can get. One last thing about the battle circle. Your actions have proven you worthy of facing our best in the circle. Perhaps we can face each other there. See you at camp.
A moment. That beast there. Do you see it? The force flows even through these simple creatures. If you empty your mind, you may be able to feel its thoughts. They aren't fully formed. Basic instincts, primal urges, every breath dominated by the needs of the moment. Good. Beasts can be easier to affect than other sentients, but you must bridge the gap between what distinguishes us and them. You feel its thoughts, yes? Like a low rumble before the storm. Use the force to create a barrier around it, carefully and slowly. You came close, and you have the potential. With practice, you can make any animal passive. But the cage around their perceptions is a fragile thing. Many things can break its hold. Violence, especially. With the force, anything is possible. But that is the end of the lesson for now. You or causes you fear is not strength. Facing it is. I have seen you display many acts of mercy, charity in our journey. Why? Even if it weakens their spirit, even if it robs them of the strength needed to grow, you have been chased, hounded since our first meeting, and it has only made you stronger, more capable. From such small points, from such critical points, the universe and its masses may be moved. That is why you must be careful in all that you do and in every choice you make. Aiding them gives you strength by taking on their challenges, but weakens them. If that is your choice, then use their dependence and feed upon it until you have exhausted them. Then leave them. And I would view the ones you travel with much the same way. So you may think, but it will be best to strike first. Your allies are allies by circumstance, and they will not hesitate to do the same to you if you continue down your path.
I have felt it too, my lord. A disturbance in the force.
Mm-hmm.
It was difficult to make out, my lord. At first it was such a quiet thing. I did not notice it. But now I wonder as if it has always been there. I merely could not hear it before. The sound built so slowly. Yet when you listen for it, you can make out the strains, even over the background life of the universe. Do you feel it is a... You are the darkness in which all life dies, my lord. All life exists to feed your power. And my life is yours. I beg you, please, let me die. Yes, this disturbance echoes through the Force. I can follow it to its source and bring it to you. I will leave at once, my lord.
What is it?
I'm Kumis, and Zargo is not wrong in thinking me dead. We assume that any Mandalorian who does not report back within a day has been taken by the jungle. I still live. I'm just in a difficult situation. A patrol was sent to look for weapon caches in this region. They found three sites that looked promising. Zarga told me to prove myself by taking explosives to those sites and uncovering the caches, if they exist. This was the first site. After easily dispatching some Maras, I removed my pack and began to plant my charges along this ridge. When I finished setting the charges, I looked down to see Kanok swarming all over my pack. The pests were eating everything. I killed the Kanok, but then a herd of Bomas arrived. I had no more ammo. The extra energy cells I had brought had been in my pack. So I've been up here, weaponless, for 2 days. You must have cleared a path through the beast coming here. If you take care of the Boma beast, I can make it to safety. My blaster rifle's been useless ever since I used it to bash in a Kanok skull. Your actions are worthy of a Mandalorian. Return here when you have slain the beast and I will be able to return to camp.
Stranger, I'm returning to the Mandalorian
camp now, I won't forget this. I have only one request. Please, don't mention this incident to anyone.
I have no love for Mandalorians, but just letting him starve up there, I think you did the right thing. You never know.
Zakeg is just up ahead. Together, we have a chance of defeating it. We go into the clearing and attack it. Either it dies or we do. Beasts of the jungle are fierce and powerful. Straightforward plans work the best. They're heavily armored. They aren't particularly agile, but if they connect, it can be deadly. But a skilled patrol of warriors can kill the beasts. Then we fight.
Into the jungle. Stay alert. Let's go.
Davril has already told me of your battle with the Zakeg. You robbed my men of a worthy test, but you have gained some honor for yourself in the process. You'd make a formidable Mandalorian.
I heard you defeated a Zakeg. Ready to head back to your ship?
You hear a gloat over you, so what?
Progress with the repairs or the phase pulse converter?
You do? Let me see.
I don't know how, but these pieces look in good enough shape to repair. I'll have the telemetry computer repaired in no time. I'll be sure to tell Mandalore how much help you've been. I know you didn't ask, but here's a reward anyway. Mandalorians are expected to do anything they can to help, but you're a stranger, and you didn't have to help us.
You found Kumas.
and alive, no less. I suppose I should offer my gratitude. He's got a mind like a stunned Minok, but he's got courage. He was evasive when I asked him what happened, however. Trying to survive in the jungle must have taken its toll. We'll see if Kumis will prove warrior enough to be worth all this trouble.
I was able to make it back to camp without encountering any other beasts. You have my gratitude. Please, don't tell anyone what happened. If the others were to know, I would be disgraced.
The Mandalorians will rise again!
Says you are worthy enough to face champions. You may fight in the battle circle again. You have enough honor to face a champion of the previous day. Kelborn, what are your terms?
Swords only. No items or the Jedi's force. And no sword of the Jedi's choosing. Just a simple long blade.
Kelborn chooses to fight with the blade. You may fight with fist, foot, and the blade provided. No using the force or any other item. The match between Jedi and Kelborn is over. The Jedi is the clear and honorable victor. I underestimated you. A difficult admission for a Mandalorian. If you fight in the circle again this day, you will face the bravest and strongest of us, Braylor.
So the Jedi Order isn't completely dead. I have studied.
Here to watch a fight? We eagerly look forward to this fight. Braylor, you are our champion. How would you fight the Jedi?
No terms today, Sergeant. I would fight the Jedi with all of her arsenal.
Braylor will fight you as you are. Still, no killing and no leaving the battle circle. But you may use whatever else you want. Between Jedi and Braylor is over. The Jedi is the clear and honorable victor. You have defeated the most worthy of us. You walk away the champion of the battle circle this day. We will not forget your deeds or the honor you have earned this day.
You defeated Braylor in the battle circle. Either you're very lucky, or you're a lot tougher than you look. Kelborn said you dispatched some covert military scouts in the jungle with him. He spoke highly of your work. Zuka told me you helped out with some repairs around the base. I was hoping you'd prove yourself more with a lightsaber, but it's certainly a great help. The gate guard said you managed to kill a Zakig. Those are tough beasts, Jedi. You've earned some respect around here. Zarga told me that you returned one of our sheep to the herd. You have gained some small prestige by helping Kumis. How many Kanoks did you have to kill to find those parts for Zuka? That was a tremendous help. I won't forget it. You've made quite a reputation around here. You did better than I thought you could.
I was planning on heading to Isis tomorrow, but I'll move up the timetable and take you now.
You won't be able to get to the Ebon Hawk from the city. If you need to grab anything from your ship, I'd do it now. I know, it made quite a racket. Good work. That's to be expected. They don't really like it when someone makes loud noise in their territory.
It wouldn't be much of a test if all you had to do was take a hike through the jungle, now would it? You're alive, in one piece, and learn something about the beasts of the jungle.
Hey, General, are you all right? You look like you've been standing too close to one of my shield generators. Whoa, claws out today, aren't they? Seriously, you don't look that way from spending extra time in the fresher. I've seen other Jedi, not many but a few, who looked like that. And I feel a little strange around you. A little more in control, calm. Like I usually only get when I'm repairing something. All right, if you don't want to talk about it, I won't press you. Was there something you wanted me for? Let me see what you have. That's everything. Now all you need is a little quiet time with the workbench.
It is as I heard through the Force, my life for yours. Kill me, I beg you. It was not my wish to challenge you, and I must pay the price. I have nothing to offer you. Your strength is superior. It is as I felt.
Now I've seen everything. This woman, she's a Miraluka. I didn't think any were left in this part of the galaxy. Yeah, They're a pretty secretive race. I heard that some of their kind become Jedi, but a Sith? Well, that's a new one. I'm not sure how you'd go about killing one. It'd be tricky. I heard they had a colony on the Midrim, almost halfway between Onderon and Dantooine. Then, it wasn't there anymore. The whole planet was wiped out. Nothing left alive. No one knows why. Well, some of her wounds are pretty bad. Looks like she was already carrying her share of scars, though. I think she'll recover, yeah. But you look different. It's hard to explain, but it's good to see. It shows. It's kind of inspiring, to be honest. Anyway, just wanted to mention it. I think the others have noticed it too. All right, what did you want to know?
To serve. If we enter battle, I will fight and die alongside you. I have not heard that question in some time. My flesh is healed, if that's the answer you seek. The scars are many and the causes equally so. It is of no importance. I felt you. Heard you through the Force. It was like a sound at the edge of hearing. And when I heard it, I found I could not ignore it. I serve my master. I am an emissary, a scout. My master was aware of a disturbance in the Force, but was unaware of its nature, of you. The disturbance is not something one feels from a living thing. There is little my master does not know. And that you eluded his sight for so long is significant. But I do not know why. You cannot. His vessel roams the borders of known space, and even I do not know where he travels. Until he calls for me, even if I could lead you to my master, I cannot permit you to find him until you are ready. If I bring you before my master, untested, without your potential realized, then you will be lost to me, and I cannot allow that to happen. It would be as if one brought fire to a paradise valley, shattered a cavern of rare crystal, or blinded a painter. I cannot, I will not. I would die first, and gladly, to preserve you, untouched, unharmed. Now that I have found you, I cannot sacrifice what I have found. You will meet my master. It is inevitable. I have seen it. And when you stand before him and realize what you face, you must be prepared. Until then, I must protect you, help you, until you are ready. There's a greatness in you. A greatness that does not stem from the Force. It stems from who you are. And if my master does not understand you, cannot see you, then perhaps there is hope for us all. But if you seek to survive, then you must understand why this is so. There is much I see my master cannot. I fear it is because of my nature, the nature of my race. My people spend their lives seeing the galaxy, the energy streaming off stars, the growth of life, all things touched by the Force. It is not a subject which I have spoken of since its destruction. I've heard tales of Malachor. It is said that many of my people felt the end of the Mandalorian Wars from across the galaxy. But do not mistake me. I did not mean to draw comparisons between Katar and Malachor. My homeworld still exists. It is intact. I am not certain I did. I was there when the planet died. To see everything around you extinguished, it was as if I was blinded. It was as if the Force had been bled from the world. I imagine there are worse deaths, worse pain. But if there are, I do not know them. I was the only living thing remaining on the planet of Katar. And my life, my agony, was a flicker in the darkness that was the planet. All that I had been connected to had been severed. Yes, but it was not survival. I still wonder what would have happened if I had died with the others. If perhaps there would have been some way to hide my presence from the galaxy. If only I had not felt that pain, that loss, as strongly as I did. But it could not be done. When the life was bled from the planet, and yet somehow I remained, my master came for me. He walked upon the surface of my dead world, and there, lying in the bodies of my race, he took me for his own. And he made me see. And for the first time, I saw the galaxy. And I wished to die. To this galaxy, my world, absent the currents and spectrums of the Force, was nothing but crude matter, rock, flesh, emptiness. He showed the flickering of life on other planets. The mass of beings that swarmed through the empty places of the galaxy. To see such creatures, disconnected from themselves, their world, their place in it, unable to see the currents and how they affected everything around them. He showed me to make me believe in his cause. He convinced me the galaxy, all life, must die. He fed upon its ugliness, its screaming, and in its place, he left silence. And where there was chaos, he brought stillness and order. It was not a thing done with machines or weapons. The Force is far more terrible. And it touches more lives than any machine can hope to slay. For everyone that feels the Force, strongly, deeply, each one feels and perceives it in their own way. You have strengths, whether you know it or not. And my master has his. His power is great, and it comes from hunger. He is a wound in the Force, more presence than flesh. And in his wake, life dies, sacrificing itself to his hunger. And those who feel the Force strongly are beacons to his hunger. My people, my planet, would have been attacked in time. It was inevitable. Yet we could do nothing about it. The Jedi, the last council of the Jedi, came to our world to meet in secret. They hoped that perhaps among our people, they could achieve the clarity to see what was striking them from the darkness of the galaxy. They succeeded, but only in bringing him from the outer regions. And Katar, with my kind, with the Jedi upon its surface, could no longer be ignored. And my people died, and the Jedi died. And there was no one left, only me. He cannot deny his hunger for long, and any gathering of Jedi is something he cannot long resist. And now that the Jedi are vanishing, I do not know what will happen. Perhaps he will grow strong enough to eradicate all life, merely with his presence. They hoped to see the threat that had been stalking them, and they did. But they were unprepared for the magnitude of the threat. He cannot deny his hunger for long. And any gathering of... enough. I will answer what I can. I am not familiar with the place you speak of. But there are others who may move more freely, who may have been responsible for such an act of destruction. There are many factions within the Sith, all seeking to take what little remains in the wake of the Jedi Civil War. Where one moves, it is not always known to the others. But their purpose is the same: the death of all Jedi, everywhere. They believe you are the last of the Jedi, and their hatred of the Jedi unites them. All their eyes are upon you, and it is a terrible, quiet darkness that pursues you. My people once had the power to perceive. That sight may manifest itself in many ways. My sight has been damaged. My master, when he showed me my world, showed it to me as it is. But after traveling with you, only when one suffers do certain truths become. If you wish to know, perhaps it is possible to show another what my people say. First, you must close your eyes. The surface of the ship, its sights, will only be a distraction. Now, in your mind, reach out. Listen for my breathing. Do not focus on the sound, but the life behind it. Imagine its energy, its texture, in tandem with the breathing. And then in your mind, step back from the image and see what remains. There. It is not as difficult as I thought. You learn quickly. It will take effort to maintain such sight, but you now have that power, and with it you can use it to see life around you in a different way. Forgive me, but before you go, I must ask. Why do you do this? Why do you seek to help me? Teach me. You must not do this. I cannot allow you to weaken yourself for me. So you say, but it is not something I have observed or seen. I remember little of my homeworld before I entered my master's service. It is not as it was. It is not a subject.
Are you ready to go to Isis yet? Kelborn told me that they were covert military and probably aligned with Colonel Tobin from Isis. Kelborn doesn't think they'll send out any more scouts, but that doesn't mean there aren't more of them out there. Colonel Tobin is General Vaklu's right-hand man. Despite his martial skill, he handles himself as a functionary more than a warrior. Back when we were fighting Vaklu's resistance during the Mandalorian Wars, Vaklu wouldn't have any use for a poisonous Kinrath like Tobin. But Vaklu seems to have adapted well to peacetime. When you were last here, you probably didn't even go to Onderon.
The Republic knew that Onderon's fate would be decided on its jungle moon, not the planet itself. To begin with, when you talk about Onderon, you're really talking about the ancient walled city of Isis. It's the only inhabited settlement on the planet. I don't blame you. They're a sad people. I have some things to look into. I'll talk to you later. Are you ready to go to Isis yet? I'm going to talk with Zuka and have him start a shuttle flight check. After that, we'll head out. How are the port stabilizers?
They check out Mandalore. All systems are green.
Good. I want the shuttle bound for Onderon within the hour. What do you want?
Is all in readiness?
It is. Like I promised. Why? You want to back out now?
My only concerns are for the one you escort to Onderon, Mandalorian. Would you do any less for one of your clan?
Don't pretend to understand us. We Mandalorians are a breed apart.
If by apart you mean scattered, broken, and lost, then yes, you are correct.
Not for long. Soon the Mandalorians will be strong again, united as one clan under one banner. Mine.
Ah, yes. The Great Crusade. After the first one was ended by Revan and the Jedi. Such a defeat was merciful, an echo of the end, when your ships were in flames, crushed in the grip of Malachor V. But I do not need to remind you of such things.
I was at Malachor V, and I remember how many Jedi died to stop us there. And no matter how many dead orbit that planet, the Mandalorians still live. Clan Ordo still lives. See Kex there? He was serving on Nar Shaddai's muscle for the Hutts. Kelborn was a scout for the Duros on Frontier Worlds. I brought them here, gave them a purpose. This galaxy will be ours again, I promise you. That is the future.
Indeed. The future is always in motion. It is a difficult thing to see. Perhaps there will be no New Age Mandalore, no great Mandalorian crusade. Perhaps your people fought their last battle at Malachor V, and you have been dying ever since, a quiet death that will last centuries. And perhaps all that remains will be what I see before me. A man wounded by a Jedi, encased in a Mandalorian shell, hunted by the thought of being the last of the Mandalorians.
You've got some guts talking to me like that. You think your age or your Jedi whelp are going to keep you safe from me?
No, Mandalore, you are wrong. I hope that it is you who will keep the one I travel with safe. You are loyal, and you have served many masters, even following them into darkness. Do you wonder where he wanders now, Mandalore? Why he betrayed you at the end, cast you down, left you broken at the edge of the galaxy?
How do you know that?
I know many things, and I can answer the question that burns within your shell, Mandalore. But there is a price. You must keep the one I travel with safe. She is important to me, more important than anything. Show the same loyalty you have shown in the past, Mandalore. If there is a Mandalorian crusade, let it be for something that will carry your people's memory into the future. So when the time comes when there are no more Mandalorians, then at least their honor will remain. The one I travel with has walked your same path, and I ask that when the end comes, that you remember that kinship, even if it seems there is nothing else left.
Forget the Jedi. Keep your eyes on her.
One, two, three.
Mandalorians, we've got company. Stealth targets have breached our perimeter.
Wait a moment. I sense there is a disturbance in the camp. Our enemy has tracked us here. I did not expect them so soon. How did they get here, I wonder? Regardless, we must eliminate them all. None of them can escape. Our whereabouts must remain a secret. Let us join the battle. Our allies will need our help.
Thank you.
If we head to Isis immediately, grab your gear. My men will take care of cleaning up the mess.